All right, what's up, everybody? All right, now get excited, guys. Get excited. Another opportunity to live. Okay? Another opportunity to live, guys. You're living. You're alive. Okay? I want you to seize this opportunity. All right? Seize this opportunity. Be thankful. Thank God that you're able to see this day. I'm dead serious, guys. You got to be thankful. Put God first. Put God first in your life, all right? All right, that's a good way to start your morning. Hey, listen, guys. I want to share with you something, okay? You know how we do it, get fired up Monday, all right? Get excited about your life. You know why? Because if you don't, who will? All right? And this episode here, I want to talk about, there's a couple of things that I could talk about. But I'm going to talk about freedom or enslavement. Freedom or enslavement. All right? You was wired, you was designed to have freedom. Okay, freedom. I was doing some Bible studying, and several months back I was going through in the Old Testament, Exodus. And you know, God, he called Moses out from a burning bush and told Moses, look, Moses, I want you to go back to Egypt. Now, Moses ran from Egypt, okay? He was in Egypt for 40 years, okay? Here God is calling him from a burning bush and telling Moses, look, Moses, I want you to go and free my people. I want you to lead my people out. I want you to free them, all right? You are the leader, all right? Freedom. And that's what I want to talk about, freedom or enslavement. All right. The enemy wants you to be enslaved. Okay. All right. Wicked people. All right. With evil intent, you know, motives, want you to be enslaved. Okay. The system wants you to be enslaved. All right. You got to hear me. You got to really listen here. Okay. You being on your 9-to-5 job, thank God you have it. Thank God you have a 9-to-5 job. Okay. Thank God that you're able to provide income. Okay. For your family. Thank God for that. Amen. Amen. I'm with you on that. Okay, but you know it's more. You know it's more. All right? God has given you gifts, talents, and abilities. Okay? All right? He has given you everything that you would need, not only to impact your family, but to impact your city, your region, your community, this nation, this world. Okay? You have it. You have it, but you got to tap into it. All right? All right, you got to tap into it. You got to get outside of this world system, okay, and get into God's system. All right, God's kingdom, His idea. All right, so I'm challenging you. We're in 2018. Don't be afraid to try something new. Okay, I know we've been brought up to think a certain way. All right, but don't be afraid to try something new, to try something different. All right, that very thing that you might be afraid of trying. Okay, might be the very thing that might be able to get you out of the predicament that you're in. All right? But I see so many people, they just so afraid. They hear something new. Oh, it's so different. It's so new. I don't want to commit to it. I don't want to do it. Okay? It can be something totally different from their occupation. All right? But that very thing might be the thing that actually, what's the word I'm looking for? To unleash. Okay, is that the word I'm looking for? To release. Okay, there you go. That's what I'm looking for. The very thing to release that potential, that promise that's inside of them. All right? Sometimes, you know, when you rub two rocks together, what happens when you rub two rocks together? You get a spark. Okay? You get a spark. Friction. You get a spark. Okay? You can get some fire going if you rub it hard enough. Okay? If you tap it hard enough, you're going to get a spark. All right? And somebody that's listening right now, you need a spark. All right? But you going 9-to-5, just the way it is. You're in your little cubicle and you're just doing your thing, okay? And you set up in this system. It's this revolving system. What you do? You work, okay? You get up, you brush your teeth, you eat breakfast, you go to work, okay? You come home, you spend a little time with your family. You go to bed, take a shower, go to bed, wake up the next morning, you do the same thing. You go back to your office, doing the same thing over and over again. Okay? And you're bored out of your mind. But that's your security. Your security, that's your little security blanket, because that job is providing you a source of income. All right? But what I'm saying is, you down here on the podium. I mean, come on, guys. All right, we want you to have a CEO mentality. A CEO mentality. I want you to start owning stuff. All right, you have a business, have somebody work for you. All right, that freedom and that time with your family, for you to do the things that you want to do, to experience. But you'll never experience if you're afraid. You're afraid to try something new, afraid to try something different, okay? I'm saying, step out. You got to step out of the boat, start walking on some water, all right? So what, you fail? So what? So what? Get over it, all right? Do you realize, okay, for every salesperson, if you have a product or a service, okay, you know it's like an 80-20 rule, okay? You could present the opportunity to 100 people, and maybe out of 100, okay, 20 people would buy it, okay? And then out of 20 people, 10 people, you may have 10 people or 5 people that are superstars. Superstars meaning that they're rocking. They catch the vision. They catch it. They're excited about it, okay? They going out there and they making things happen. And you find that in every area of business, okay? Corporate America, okay? Ministry, okay? Can you imagine what would happen to a church or ministry, okay, if you didn't have people to go out, okay, and compel them to come in, to tell people to say, hey, listen, come and visit the church, come and visit the ministry. Okay, if that stopped, if that ceased, the church would cease. Okay, that church would not be able to grow. Just like a corporation would not be able to grow if they didn't have employees, if they didn't have supervisors, if they didn't have regional managers, okay? That type of thing. Then you have a vice president and then a president of the company. Come on, guys. Come on. I'm saying that you are your own CEO. You are your own CEO. All right, you, your name, your brand. Okay, whatever your name is, if your name is Michael Douglas, all right, Michael Douglas, that's your name, your brand. You are your own company. All right, so I'm just challenging you guys. Don't be afraid to get out of the boat and do something. All right, you see freedom right there? Go seize it. Seize freedom. Seize freedom. All right, all those creative ideas, start using those creative ideas to bring some cash flow. All right? Multiple screens of income that's in your life, that's in your relationship. Don't be afraid to try those new relationships. All right? Don't be afraid to be a people person, even if you might not be. Okay? Don't be afraid to meet people. Don't be afraid to travel to new places. Don't be afraid to try something different. All right? I hope I'm helping somebody out there. All right? Okay. So, guys, for every vision brings provision. All right? So all you need to do is, if you have vision, don't worry. The provision for that vision will come. It'll happen. God will bring that thing in no matter what. Okay? But listen, guys, and I'm just looking on my notes here. All right, I want you to seize the opportunity, guys. Seize the opportunity. Do you guys realize that 95% of people die broke? Did you realize that 95% of the people that's breathing right now is going to die broke? That's going to die broke. Okay, only 1% is wealthy. Only 1% is wealthy, and I want you to be part of that 1%. Okay, but 1% people are not afraid to try something different. Not afraid to try something new. They're in position. That's what I'm saying, guys. They're in position. When opportunity comes, man, they seize the opportunity. They seize the opportunity. You know, if they're willing to invest in something, look, they're willing to lose it. If they have money, that they already got that money already accounted for, meaning that they're willing to invest. They're willing to lose that money or to invest in whatever project that it might be, whatever business opportunity it might be, whatever relationship it might be, whatever ministry it might be, all right? They're not afraid to lose it, all right? And that's what I just want to share with you guys, okay? You guys are hanging on so tight, your security blanket, okay? That opportunity is coming your way and you're not seizing the opportunity. You're not seizing the opportunity. I'm just saying, You're not seizing the opportunity. I mean, opportunities that can make you wealthy beyond your wildest dreams, put you in a better position, you and your family. But you're afraid to seize the opportunity. I know I'm going a little bit long here, but I just want to just make sure I drill this in, okay? Multiple streams of income, okay, that's right here. It's right up in here. But if you don't get it right here, you got to get it right here, guys. Got to be in your heart. You got to believe this thing. Okay? But it starts with your mindset. Okay? It starts with your mindset, guys. So, listen, I'm about to go ahead and wrap it up. I'm already done. But listen, guys, I want you to get excited about your life. You know why? Because if you don't, I'm going to say it again. Because if you don't, who will? Who will? God said this, love God with all his heart. Love God with all your heart, mind, soul, being. And then love your neighbor as yourself. Love, and there's a lot of people that's walking around not loving themselves. All right, guys, I'm out of here. I'll talk to you later. Get fired up about your life, because if you don't, who will? Make sure you go to igniteyourvisionnow.com. Like, look, guys, push, click the like button if you like this message, okay? And subscribe so that other people can be able to see this and be empowered by this, all right? I love you guys, and I'll talk to you soon. All right, now, this is Dave. I'm out of here. Bye-bye.